What, 16 or 15? Yeah. You just need to take care of the ball. And that's the biggest thing, take care of the ball. And we knew the pressure was going to be there. We knew they were going to attack the rim. Everything that I said to them they were going to do, they did. They let a lot of things go out there. You know, they were letting us play. And so we got to be able to handle that kind of pressure.
They started it right from the beginning. You had four turnovers in the first minute.
Yes, exactly. Yeah. Exactly. It's just a matter of holding on to that one. You know, we have a couple girls that can handle the ball. You know, I mean, physically, we're a little bit weaker, I would say, than, you know, some teams that we play. But I think my girls play good, solid basketball. They were able to hold on and fight. You know, I told them when teams are giving you that much pressure, you know, and hitting you in certain spots, you know, you've got to be able to give that same intensity back. Shouldn't have been. I don't know what they got within, what, 5 or 6 at one point.
Seven.
Yeah. I mean, like a football game. Mm-hmm.
It really was.
And that they were throwing you off, but you were able to bounce it back.
Yeah, and at that point, because I had told them, you know, we need to use the clock in the fourth quarter. You know, it's our game to win. Mm-hmm. Use the clock. But when the pressure's like that, whenever you have an opportunity to attack, so when we had any kind of numbers, you know, now you got to attack. You know, now we can't hold back, you know, play that half court. Now we just got to attack.
You can't just sit back and hold the ball because that makes it into a red.
Exactly. Yeah.
I just thought the key early was you had so many turnovers in the first 3 minutes. I think they missed 21 of their first 23 shots, and you were able to kind of get control. How much did that help early getting out?
I told the team at halftime, I was like, here we're up by 15 at half. And I said, not playing good basketball at all. We're up 15. And my point guard said, it doesn't feel like 15. I was like, exactly, because we're not playing good basketball. Mm-hmm. They happen to be missing like a lot in most of their shots. Mm-hmm. So, you know, we're fortunate. Mm-hmm. We're fortunate in that first half. We didn't play well. A lot of my girls aren't feeling well. I'm not feeling well. So I told them, I was like, this is a push-through day. Mm-hmm. At the end of the day, when we come out with a W, mm-hmm. you're going to feel good about it. And we go home, we take care of ourselves, get your rest, you know, get ready to come back on Saturday. It's just one of those push-through days. But we do need to start off strong. And that's kind of one of my biggest things with these guys. Got to start
off strong.
It's
a push-through game?
Yes. It really was.
How big was it? Because the first time you played Poly, you didn't have your whole team. Today you had your whole team. Even though you guys weren't maybe 100%, at least you did have your full troop.
Yeah, we do. We have 4 girls injured this year. They're just not going to be back. So we know that. So yes, we were full strength. And a big piece of that was Kayla Mitchell. She was sick early in the season, so she wasn't able to be here for that game. And she's been doing a phenomenal job for us coming off the bench. You know, so her offensive game brings so much to the team, and she can handle the ball as well. That certainly helped us a ton. It's really helped us a ton to have her out there.
I thought it was really unusual in the first quarter with all the turnovers, but they kept their poise. They just kept their poise, and Holly was rushing it, and you were forcing them to rush it by playing good defense. Your defense was good.
Yeah, I'll tell you what, the one thing that keeps us in every single game that we play is our defense.
Kept you today.
And even this past week when we played Parkdale, we started in the zone, we had to go man. And our man defense is phenomenal. It's just, yeah, our defense keeps us in games. It's just figuring out how to execute better offensively in the half. We do still need to execute better. We're better than we were early.
Right.
I watched our game against Holly, you know, this week preparing, and I was like, we played terrible. And we were in that game. We were up 9 with 3 minutes left in that game.
Yeah.
We lost for 41-35.
We lost in overtime. The score was tied up.
To Holly,
Clay fouled out with 3 minutes left. And we couldn't hold the lead, but it's the same type of thing. The pressure. So we knew what they were all about.
Which was pressure and physical, right?
Exactly.
How much did that help you today, actually? This is different. No, having seen them, having played them.
Tremendously. We knew exactly what they had. I thought we pushed the ball well on them. I mean, that is one thing. We do score and transition quite well. It's a big part of our offense. As you can see, when we don't have it, we struggle a little bit.
But it was good.
I don't know how many points we have in transition.
But you attacked them. You were forcing them back.
Exactly.
And that was a good thing. But the fourth quarter, that has to be big, because the way they were putting pressure on you and the way they held up. You said last time you lost the 9-point lead in the fourth quarter. How much is it's a tournament game in the end. What is it? I'm not sure that it matters in general, but how much does that help their confidence?
God, a game like this is huge. I mean, this is why we put a schedule together this year like we did. You know, playing top 10 teams and playing a lot of them, because I want our girls, first of all, you know, we certainly have quality players to play against quality players. You know, we play some teams, you know, we're going to blow them out by 30 or 40. We have to have these games to prepare, well, first of all, to help the development of our kids. But, you know, you're always thinking about the playoff run.
Right.
You know, certainly we'll want to get back to the state championship. Mm-hmm. And these are the kind of games that you can kind of draw upon
right.
in those moments mm-hmm. and remember that. Wait, we handle
teachable moments.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. We started handling it better at the end. I had to change a little bit on the press break. But, you know, you can kind of think back on that. Keep your composure. I mean, the biggest thing is keeping your composure. I told them they kept their composure better than I did. They didn't have a quarter.